Hi, I'm Jeff Bradshaw from Redneck Restorations. This old truck brought to you by ElderlyIron.com. Coming up, got an issue with a Knuckle and Crusty truck. But in order to prepare for what comes next, I have taken a 7/16 tap coarse thread. It's supposed to be fine thread, but they ran a coarse thread through here already. This is the hole that was centered, at least I thought it was centered, because upon closer examination, we see that they have drilled this one out as well. So I now have three holes. I now have three holes drilled out instead of two. Get the light on it. You can see those fresh threads cutting that side and rusty on this side. Where the tap didn't quite catch it, because that's where the old stud was. So when you look at it from here, you'll see that that hole's a bit elongated, and that one's a lot elongated. When you look on the other side, it gets worse. That's where it was, stud was stuck in there, and they drilled through and missed the center. And this one, they didn't even drill through straight. And then they tapped threads, so it was part fine and part coarse. So what we have here is a big mess. So, that being the way it is, I have the little plate that goes on top here. Because I'm going to need these two holes in order to make the new bores. Plate goes on top of the right side. The steering link goes on top of the left side. This is the left side here, so the steering link goes on it. I'll show you that mess in a while. But when I go to put this bolt in, it don't work. It doesn't line up because they've drilled that hole off center. So since this hole was off center, it takes the steering link. They reamed that puppy out. Look at that. Big cone shape. Reamed that one out. Those two are almost where they're supposed to be. That's the one that's original. That's reamed out. That's just hogged out, hog wild. I don't know what I'm going to do about that, but that's for a later day. Right now we got to work on this. So I'm going to have to cut these a little bit so they line up, because I'm going to go ahead and use that old hole. And then these two will be the guide for the next two holes we put in. I don't want to take anything out of this one, because that's my alignment right there. So I have to take out of this edge. There's a bit of water in my line. It's my coolant. It keeps it cool. Makes my bits last longer. There we go. A little side-to-side play. But we shall overcome. So this gives you an indication of how far off the holes were, or are.
Anchor's hot part?
Yeah, I need a sliver under here. I touched a sliver. Not a mile.
Yeah. Father.
I had to come during the noise making session.
The camera in your way?
See, something like this.
I can feel like it.
When you speak, speak over here.
Okay.
This way.
I don't feel like it. I'm busy. Don't bother me.
Yep. Came off of there.
Close enough. Okay, close enough to know what you don't like at all.
I'm liking it, I'm liking it. I want to do something, I want to do something. Huh?
Pick your nose.
I already did that. There's nothing left to pick. Give me a short stud. Idea?
No. I'm not that smart.
Boy, I'll take.
You know, that's the only thing I don't like about this. You'll end up showing the world how ding dong I am. It's gonna be slightly like it should be like this.
Well, the main thing is, that's why I have this plate.
I know.
Honey, told you nothing yet. I know. If you know everything, Mr. Smarty Pants, you just go right to work.
I know what you're trying to do, okay? As they say, I've been around the block.
Yeah, I heard that from somebody else, too.
I said it one time, it got me in trouble.
You said it to the wrong person. Because I found out this hole was off. They drilled that out too. It's supposed to be fine for us. So I had to open up the hole in that plate a little bit. So the plate actually needs to be. I mean, that's as good as it's gonna get. So that's why the bolt is in there. It has to be in there to line up these two holes.
I know. You have a bolt for that?
I want it gone. Starting all over. Square one.
Do you have a bolt for it?
No.
But I can go find one.
I have a bolt for what's gonna be in there.
I don't care about that.
716 fine thread.
Right now, I want a bolt.
716 fine thread. Got one?
I hope so.
So now, why are you doing that? Why are you doing that?
So we can line up the other holes correctly.
What other holes?
These two.
That one is not in the right place. That's why I did this hole. This one stays. This one stays. These two get changed. See, you knew it all. You didn't. You knew it. You knew everything.
Did I ever tell you I hate you?
No, you never said that.
Keep it up,
I will. You said you wanted to kill me. You said you wanted to throw me in a ditch.
See, because now...
these two holes are way off. Right? That's because they broke off all three. This is the closest one to center that they re-drilled.
Yeah, but this one is kind of wonky.
Yeah, I know. But this is as close as it gets. Okay.
Hey, Marty, I'll do it your way. But remember,
I don't want it done my way. I want it done the right way.
Nothing gets done around here your way. It gets done my way. Well, at least old Cadillac parts are good for something.
Yes. These holes bad. This hole good.
Are you got a nut for this?
No.
Why not?
You don't need one.
What about if I insist?
Then I have to go find one.
Let's do that.
Please do those nuts. See, with two guys that know everything, we ought to get something done.
Good luck on that one. Now,
have a cigar? I did bring this just in case. 7/16. So that's a 7/16 hole. It's got to have a bore that goes all the way through that thing in a straight line from that 7/16 reference.
But nothing else gets bolted out to this, right?
What do you mean?
This is the cover and that's... it's finished when it's done there.
This is from the right side. This knuckle's from the left side. What goes on here is, well, they're identical. I can use one on either side. So I can either put the cover on this and use the good side. The steering arm goes on there.
Okay.
Which is all reamed out because they had to make it all fit.
Okay.
So what are you thinking?
For what we have, we are going to do a violation. We are going to do it my way.
So I can either go helicoil, or I can do my other plan, which was to go out to half inch thread in it, put a half inch bolt in it, cut it off, drill through the half inch bolt, and then cut the sheet thread. Sounds like a lot of work, but you just can't find these, you know what I mean?
I know, I am a chef.
But, okay. The holes in here basically good. The original. The holes inside the cabinet, I think good. No. They're in the wrong place.
No, they're not.
Yeah, they are. Because if you look on the underside of it, you see the stud is still in there. These things, this one, one of them's off the 16th, the other one's off one for the complete 8th. That's what I'm saying. It's got to be piloted so that the hole is where it's supposed to be. Then it has to be opened up to catch the rest of the garbage that's been destroyed.
I see what we're doing. Okay. First of all, and your idea is probably the best.
I win!
My thoughts were, we'll machine this hole straight out.
Where it's supposed to be.
Correct. Once we have it straight, I can go in to another drill bit or a mill.
Or reamer.
No
reamer.
Okay. We have to go drill or mill.
Okay.
And finish it through so we can tap it out. Right? Then we can take that off, put the bolt in. You know, tap it out, put the bolt in, and go to the next one.
Well, we know if we go 7/16, it's not going to work. Okay. If we go 7/16, the hole's too big. 7/16 won't bite anything. So you're going to have to go half in.
Oh, okay. I see what you're saying. No, yeah, no. No.
Hit the board straight.
Right.
And then progressively open it up.
You see, according to this, I need a 7/16 drill bit or end mill.
Okay. Okay, so 7/16 hole to tap half inch thread.
The only thing is that this hole will get bigger.
On the plate here.
Right.
It'll have to be bigger as well.
Okay.
So, now what I was trying to avoid was using a half inch bolt on here because of the way it's going to look. So, I don't have to. I mean, we can put it together and it'll be... But just for the...
I have some ideas now, so...
Okay. He has ideas. Master Retro Redneck Frustrations. This old truck brought to you by ElbowandIron.com. And coming up, got a little issue in Operation Crusty Truck. Take two. On your way. But, in order to prepare for what comes next... I'm Jeff Retro of Redneck Restorations. This old truck brought to you by Elderly Iron. Take three. May I come back now?
Yeah, you can come back.
Hi, I'm Jeff Retro. Take four.
Because I'm going to need these two holes in order to make the new bores. And then I take this 7/16 coarse thread bolt.
Like, it should be like this. Like that.
Well, if we stick a shim under here, it'll work, won't it?
Keep it up, I'm going home.
So, that's like that. So, that being the way it is,
nothing gets done around here your way. It gets done my way.
I'm Jeff Bradshaw, Redneck Restorations. This old truck. Take five.